Hey there, Mr. Reddit here. Welcome back to another episode of r/EntitledParentStories. Our first story we'll be reading today. Excuse me, why is there an automatic 18% gratuity for parties of 6 or more? After that, my house, my rules. Okay. And after that, am I the jerk for not letting my mother identify as a grandmother to my kid on social media? Now for every thumbs up this video gets, one Karen has to leave a 16% tip. How about a 20% tip? As long as we use your card, Reddit boy. So please smash that like button. And if you're new, subscribe and turn on notifications for new stories from Reddit every single day. Excuse me, why is there an automatic 18% gratuity for parties of 6 or more? Because large parties are an extra burden to bear. Because if one person's section is bogarted by a large party, their night is sink or swim based on your charity. Because the number one reason service staff will have a breakdown or spontaneously quit their job is getting done over on a large bill. Automatic gratuity is there to protect the staff and the business. Cue this one high maintenance sort and his family of 12. Despite their best efforts to run me ragged, everything went super smooth and genial. Then came the bill.
Excuse me, but why is there an 18% gratuity? I'd like to write in my own tip.
And you can. There's a line below where you can add whatever you'd like on top of the gratuity, and it's much appreciated.
No, no, no. I'm talking about the principal. I always tip above 20%.
Big, moment.
But having it forced on the customer feels unfair.
Me, playing coy. Well, if you wanted to tip above 20%, you can just add the 2% or whatever on the tip line underneath.
It's the principal.
I just thanked him and walked away. He sat there stewing for 15 minutes while his family was polishing off desserts and gathering their things to leave. A situation best ignored until they leave. And sure enough, he had signed the bill. No extra tip. Shocked Pikachu face. But managed to write out an entire novel on the front and back of his bill, addressed to the owner, detailing why automatic gratuities are the worst thing ever and how much more he would have tipped if it wasn't an imposition. Basically could have just written underneath, "Too long didn't read, I'm a cheap jerk." One of my first service jobs was at a corporate place where the gratuity was conditional on large parties, and at best, you could only ask the party for permission to apply it. Most said sure, fine, but of course. So one night, my entire section is cordoned off for a large party of 20, mostly teenagers, and they did that obnoxious crap, like ordering steaks well done, eating half of it, then complaining they want a new one. Or asking for extra drinks when I was explicit about no free refills, but still complaining when the bill came, etc. I was gutted because I knew what was coming with the $400 bill. Hey, you guys cool if we add a gratuity?
What's that?
It's an 18% tip added to the bill to ensure staff.
Nah, it's cool. We got you.
Long sigh and head down in shame. They left me 15 bucks. My tip out on the party was 20. And I would never do over the rest of the staff, so I took a net loss of $5 for the night. I was shaking and ready to quit. Managers were all,
"Bummer, but it's like that. See you tomorrow."
I worked the slow lunch shift the next morning, and as soon as the rush was starting to hit, the general manager comes up to me.
"Hey, I'm gonna cut you and send you on break for a couple of hours. I'm gonna need you to come back in tonight."
I was so checked out. "No, I'm not scheduled and already have plans. Sorry." His eyes got big. The next morning, I tried clocking in, and the point of sale didn't recognize my number. GM had decided to can me on some trumped up BS, but it was clearly because I had been insubordinate. Good riddance. Well, how about when you go out to eat? How much of a tip do you usually leave? Please let us know.
Reddit boy and I usually leave 20%, unless it's very poor service. Then we speak to their manager.
My house, my rules. Okay. So a few years ago, my dad was moving out of his house and in with his parents due to some health problems with my grandma. This was over summer break, and I was just out of high school at the time, about to go into college, so I had absolutely nothing to do all summer as I waited to move out of state. My dad never was, and still isn't, super organized, whereas I alphabetized my own bookshelf with a full system, type A, about keeping things in order. Call me weird, but I really enjoy reorganizing things and cleaning. It just hits that button for me. So being that he had about 2 months until he closed on the house, I just start to pack up some of the house for him. Basement was a disaster, and I had wanted to tear it up for years. So within the first day, I had made a significant dent in the basement, which ended up being a very involved process. I didn't realize when we had moved in that a lot of the stuff from our old house was still packed haphazardly because my brother and I were too young to really help. So I went through the process of unpacking the still packed boxes from house 1, labeling the boxes the way I wanted to, and then repacking those boxes appropriately. After about 3 days of this, I get about 50% done, including cleaning and packing my room and some of the garage. Here's the build-up to the malicious compliance. My dad comes down to help me, all good with me. I start explaining where things go, and my dad wants to change it. I resist, explaining that I already have the system and that I have been doing the bulk of the packaging, so he should probably just go with me on this one, which is when he hits me with the namesake of this post. So I relent because I know what will happen. Anyone that's really type A will agree with me that the only thing more frustrating than things being chaotic and out of order is things that are slightly out of order, which is what I knew would happen. Regardless of the fight Dad and I had, he ended up almost following the system. Mostly things that belong in the labeled boxes went where they were supposed to, except for a few very important odds and ends that got put, well, not where they were supposed to. I noticed this, but because of my house, my rules, clearly he has a plan, so I don't say anything. I knew the payoff was going to be a slow burn, and it came several months later when I was in school across the country and unable to help. Dad calls me one day very flustered because he can't find something he needed. He had been in the storage unit he rented in my hometown for the better part of 3 hours looking. Now, the storage unit got packed horribly by the moving crew. I've been in there a few times after this story, and I feared for my safety. It's a legitimate labyrinth slash jungle gym and a nightmare to get through. Not to mention, this was midsummer and there was no AC. So Dad is mad on the phone asking me where it is, and I ask him if it's in the box I labeled in big red Sharpie, important stuff. He says no, and I smile a bit. Then he says, "Well, you were in charge of packing all of this stuff, and now I can't find it." That's when I calmly reminded him of the blowout fight we had over this exact issue and how he commandeered my operation afterwards. I told him that if I was actually in charge, it would be in the box labeled important stuff. He hung up on me after that. I love my dad, and I had no problem helping him out. We laugh about it today, but I can't say I didn't get a good chuckle at the thought of him sweating and climbing around in that storage unit. He recently found another place to live now that my grandparents have more in-home assistance, and I've already worked out that I'm gonna come help him move. We already agreed I'm in charge this time. How do you like your house to be? Organized or messy? Please let us know.
Oh, I can't stand messes. Don't you see how neat and tidy our bookshelves are?
Am I the jerk for not letting my mother identify as a grandmother to my kid on social media? There's a lot of background to this, but the short version is that I, then 17, now 27, female, got pregnant as a teenager, stayed with the baby daddy, had another kid with him, then he dumped me. Mom, then 39, now 49, said some really horrible things and refused to act as a grandma to my 2 kids, ages 7 and 9. I'm now married to someone else, and we had a baby back in January. Now that I've had a child in wedlock, Mom wants to be a grandma. Can't find a place to slip this in organically, but my husband also had a child from before the marriage, a 4-year-old, whom Mom treats the same as my older kids. I didn't even tell her when I had my newborn, and she found out along with everyone else when I announced the birth on social media a couple of weeks ago. The actual birth occurred a few months ago. We held off on announcing until last month. When we announced on Facebook, this was also when Mom learned that the baby had been born. I already told Dad and stepmom personally. This caused a fight between us, and I blocked her for a bit. I've unblocked her a few days ago, gone on her profile, and literally the top 10 posts are just about being a grandma. I then made a few passive-aggressive comments on her posts about how she's been a grandma for almost a decade now, and she's never met my newborn. A few hours later, I saw my comments had been deleted, so I posted on my page that I was incredibly grateful to my baby's grandparents, my dad, my stepmom, and my husband's parents for all of the love and support that they had shown me, my husband, my kids, and this baby, and how grateful I was for family. A few people were like, "OP, you forgot your mom," and I just responded that everyone who should have been mentioned is mentioned already.
Mom has called me and yelled and cried over the phone, saying I'm a horrible daughter and making her feel and look like a bad mother slash grandmother, and I need to take that post down. I refused. This has caused a schism with several people thinking I shouldn't have aired our dirty laundry in public, and that my mom's posts do nothing to affect me while my post was designed to hurt mom, so I should take my post down, while the other camp think that she deserved it, and I nearly corrected public record. Info: she only wants to be grandma to the baby. The elder kids, 7, 9, and stepkid, 4, are not allowed to call her grandma because it makes her feel old. Am I the jerk? Well, who do you think is the jerk? OP or her mom? Please let us know.
When is grandma's birthday? Maybe we can get her a heart.
French Karen upset I speak English in England. I work at a company that has over 300 sites globally. I work in the only plant in the UK. We have 22 people who work here. I was asked to join a call with our other European sites, as I also speak German fluently and can understand and speak Italian to a level about the industry I work in. So we have this call and we have English, me, Greek, Turkish, Romanian, Italian, German, Spanish, and French on the meeting. Everyone at the other plants has management and can all speak English. Italian and German is broken English, hence why it's easier for me to be on it and translate if they struggle understanding anything in English. So we go about the meeting, and German starts talking to me in German. I'm translating, and it's all going well, and we all know each other well as we've regularly visited each other's plants. Apart from France, they have a new woman, Karen, who keeps trying to be the center of attention. She's been speaking fluent English all through the call so far. I'm translating the German and Italian. It's all going well. Until Karen starts speaking French. I told her I didn't know French. It's already confusing enough with three languages. The conversation goes as follows. Karen:
what do you mean? You're the translator.
Me: no, I'm a chemist. I know German fluently and Italian to a level. It's relevant to this call. Karen:
well, why are you making me speak a second language, but learning everyone else's?
Me: I'm doing the company a favor. Otherwise, they would have to get a translator.
Oh, I get it. It's because I'm new and I'm a woman.
Me: I'm also a woman. No, I just never learned French.
Oh, so it's a personal thing now?
Me: you speak English. You don't need it to be translated, or it to be all about you. Karen hung up. Next day, reported me to HR for bullying. I don't think she realized that the call was recorded, so I sent a copy to HR. Unfortunately, at my company, you have a 6-month probation. This happened at 3 months of her being here, and throwing out stupid accusations like this means you're probably not going to make it. Am I the jerk for calling my mother-in-law toxic after she ruined my birthday unintentionally? For context here, I, male 28, and my husband, male 30, have been married for 3 years and we've been friends for even longer. When I was 18, so I know his mother very well by now. She's a bubbly person and enjoys being the life of the party. I always thought well of her, and she was supportive of our friendship and there for me through a rough patch. My parents aren't the best people in the world, long story short. However, things got strained when we entered a relationship in our early 20s. My husband is her only child. She had him young, and his father was out of the picture before his birth. So it really had just been them for most of his life, really. I think she suddenly felt like she was losing him when we announced we were together, and later on that we were moving away from the small city we grew up in. Even though I've always made the effort to get along with her and encourage him to spend time with her, because sometimes he's reluctant. Anyway, I've noticed a pattern of behavior that has progressively gotten worse, especially since we got married and during the wedding process. Passive-aggressive behavior against me, for the smallest things. I didn't know his coffee order once, and she joked that if I didn't know him well as her, why was I with him? Like, what? And one big example. She made a crude speech at our wedding, one implying I had cheated on my husband. I have several close male friends, but that's all that's going on there. Though she brushed it off as a joke at the time. You get the gist. I always try to ignore it, and my husband doesn't seem to want to confront it either. Because of lockdown, I had a low-key birthday, just a very small gathering with drinks in the back garden. However, that day she complained repeatedly through text that she wasn't feeling well, but insisted it wasn't lockdown related and described her symptoms in detail, stating she felt it was anxiety related
and that she had to come to the party. Living alone is making her stir crazy, which I get. So after the cake, I was talking with my husband, and my mother-in-law just faints. It was awful. The whole party stopped, but it was odd. She woke up really quickly and seemed fine. But after that, she wouldn't let my husband leave her side, but refused help. I got frustrated because why did she have to come if she felt unwell? I made one comment about her maybe staying home next time, and she went off, saying that my tone was off and I'm trying to isolate her further during a lockdown. I said, no, you're now putting words in my mouth and you're toxic. It just burst out. I tried apologizing. My husband just stood there and said that maybe we both needed to calm down and enjoy the party. But my mother-in-law says she should go home if I didn't want her there anyway, and did exactly that. Things have been tense since. She's texting him a lot, but I've ignored her. I needed to collect my thoughts. Was I the jerk for lashing out at her? Well, who do you think is the jerk? OP or mother-in-law? Please let us know.
Definitely mother-in-law, as usual.
She told me to do exactly what she says, and I did. I'm a secretary for a medical facility that funds other medical institutions. I'm also responsible for their travel to conventions and conferences. There is a very large and very highly attended conference held each year in which our medical professional staff are invited as presenters. One such Karen-esque presenter just had to be incredibly difficult, as she feels she is above us and never lets us forget it. As a presenter, they are given certain hotels that are reserved for them at a reduced rate. However, most are nowhere near the convention site, and they end up paying a crap load of money for cabs. No Uber at the time. I set up the travel for at least 10 folks when I realized that by a loophole, I can book them into the hotel where the conference is held. So I do that instead of allowing the conference coordinators to book them in heaven knows where at the last minute, which they are prone to do. Karen comes up to me and demands that I only book her into the hotels listed by the conference coordinators, and if I don't, she will have me written up. So that's what I did. The day before they all leave for the conference, which was clean across the country on the West Coast, Karen found out she was not only the only one not booked in the conference hotel, but she was 9 miles away near the airport. And no, there were no more rooms available at the conference hotel. She was hopping mad and stormed to my desk screaming about me putting her in a faraway two-star hotel. I looked at her and calmly stated that she was in one of the three hotels the conference coordinators reserved for her, and she distinctively instructed me to only select those hotels and nothing else. She ended up spending more than $70 in cab fare to and from the hotel to the venue, while everyone else only had to go downstairs from their hotel rooms. She almost missed giving her presentation because she was late. After that, when I booked everyone for a trip, Karen no longer demanded I give her special treatment and lets me use my judgment when booking hotels. Am I the jerk for suggesting my wife take our kids strawberry picking when she's allergic to strawberries? My kids are craving to go strawberry picking at a local produce farm. I was going to try and take them, but I'm an ICU nurse and I work from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. Monday through Friday and on weekends, so I'm tired and I can hardly move. I've been trying to get my wife to take them, but she refuses because she's allergic. The thing about her allergy is it only takes effect if she actually eats a strawberry. She can hold strawberries, she can breathe in their scent, she can touch them, and she doesn't suffer anaphylaxis, she just gets a rash that goes away with Benadryl within one day. So she refused to take them for that reason. The thing is, the kids are cooped up all day long. They're doing online homeschool from 7 a.m. to 1 p.m., and after their school day is over, they can either play in the house or in the yard, because my wife won't take them anywhere. My wife is an extreme introvert and homebody, and her idea of a great day is sitting on our covered porch with a book or a sketch pad and a cup of coffee. My wife can easily spend an entire day in the same spot on the porch. She hates bugs, she hates dirt, she hates plants. When I take the kids on our annual hike and camp trip over the summer, she refuses to go. The kids always miss her and wish she'd go with us to share the experience. So I'm at work right now, and my son called me and asked if we were going to go strawberry picking this weekend. Unfortunately, I'm going to be stuck all weekend at the hospital because we've got two nurses out sick and someone needs to be there to take care of people, and I'm a head nurse, so I need to be there. I told him to put mom on the phone, and I tried to convince her to take them today. It's a gorgeous day. She said she was just sitting with a book and some Netflix, and the kids were playing a board game. I asked her why she couldn't take them. She said she didn't want to be around the berries in case she gets a rash. I told her there were plenty of Benadryl in the house, and we have latex surgical gloves in our bathroom first aid kit that she could wear, and she doesn't even have to touch the berries if she doesn't want to. But come on and just take the kids. They're bored and unhappy. She told me I was being a jerk and trying to get her hurt, and if I cared about her at all, I wouldn't try to get her to do this. She hung up on me and hasn't returned my calls. I'm taking a 5-minute bathroom break to create an account here and post this to get some opinions. Am I the jerk? Edit. I should add that I have an extreme allergy to dogs, where I actually do suffer mild anaphylaxis, and we still have a dog. My wife wanted a dog, and she told me that I could just use an EpiPen if I have a reaction to PD. Edit. Someone suggested I edit one of my comments into the post. My wife cooks with strawberries and buys strawberries from the grocery store because our kids adore strawberries. Our kids love strawberry shortcake and strawberry cheesecake, and she makes those for them all the time. Well, who do you think is the jerk? OP or his wife? Please let us know.
I'm really craving some strawberries now.
I was just fired for the second time after quitting years ago. Long story short, in 2014, I was working at a pizza chain in a rural Utah farming town. I won't say which one, but they're a national chain known for being very greasy. At the beginning of July, I gave a 2-week notice to my manager that I'd be leaving to move out of state to be closer to family and a better job market. I finished out my time as promised, moved, found a new, better gig, and that was that. Of course, you read the title, so you'll know that that wasn't really all. In summer of 2015, I received a call from a new store manager. He informed me that he's been putting me on schedule and it was unacceptable that I wasn't even coming in to look. If I didn't show up today, he would have no choice but to fire me. I asked, did the old manager not take me out of the system after I quit last year? He grumbled and made some snarky complaint that if I had quit a year ago, I wouldn't be in his scheduling program. I let him know I live in a completely different state, am working a completely different job, and would not be showing up for any shifts he scheduled me for. He threatened to fire me again, and I reiterated, hey, I don't actually work for you, so do what you gotta. He hung up, and that was the last I heard of it. Until we fast forward to yesterday, I received a letter from the corporate office informing me that, per their records, I haven't shown up to work since July of 2014, and unfortunately, they were going to have to terminate me. I still almost can't stop laughing, especially since, you know, they sent the letter to the address I gave them when I quit. Am I the jerk for not being honest about liking my birthday gift? So my birthday was 2 weeks ago. One of my good friends, E, got me a gift that was completely not my taste. It was a really weird looking sundress from a brand I never buy from, in a style I would never wear. I typically dress in a more androgynous slash tomboy style. I was kind of surprised because she normally gives amazing gifts and has gotten me cool stuff in the past, but because she's one of my closest friends, I didn't want to hurt her feelings. She included the receipt anyways, so I figured I'd maybe exchange it, although the brand is not what I'd normally buy from. Anyway, I thanked her when she gave it to me, feigned some joy as I opened it, and took it home with me. In my head, I was just happy to have gotten a gift. It wasn't my style, but it was still thoughtful of her to get me a present. I chalked it up to her maybe pushing me to try something new and moved on with my life. Today, we were supposed to get lunch, so I thought I'd wear the dress to meet up with her. When I showed up, she seemed really shocked and angry, and we had a pretty tense, awkward meal together. Later, I got a long, angry text from her talking about how disappointed she was. Apparently, the whole thing was a prank. She purposefully got me a dress that I would never buy myself, that she knew I wouldn't be caught dead in, to see if I'd be a good friend and tell her the truth. She had seen some dumb video on social media about giving people bad gifts on purpose to see if they're honest or not. E wanted slash expected me to open her gift and gently tell her it wasn't what I really wanted and thus pass her test. Apparently, she was planning on giving me my real gift, a vinyl of this band I really like, after I told her I didn't like the fake one. But since I lied, I didn't deserve it. I'm really taken aback. Like, what the heck? Who does that? She called me a jerk for lying to her face about loving it, and I just haven't replied to her since. I genuinely don't know what to say. This situation is just out of pocket. This is really unusual behavior for her, or anyone I'm friends with, and I really don't know what to think. Am I the jerk? Is this normal? Well, who do you think is the jerk? OP or their friend? Please let us know.
And this is why TikTok challenges must be stopped.
It wasn't Karen, it was me. Just a little background. I conked my head pretty hard on an F-18 fighter jet back in the Navy. I currently have some mild memory problems and kind of go into phases where I'm awake, but I can't really tell what I'm doing. It's an odd sensation when I'm tired or didn't eat well. I just go into this phase where I'm physically competent. I could juggle knives and tightrope, but not tell you how many fingers you're holding up or repeat your name when you tell me to my face. All this being said, it wasn't nearly that bad, which makes me feel terrible. You see, I'm 6'7" tall. I wear my hair very short, so the massive jagged scar on my head is very visible. Until people hear me talk, they usually shuffle away from me and hold their purses, kids, or whatever closer, and try to stand near someone else. It's a little offensive, but I can't blame them. Books and covers and all, but I do look like a bad guy. Now, this story is simple. I was running out of food in my fridge, and I just got off a 12-hour shift. I didn't need much. It might sound gross, but a super easy fast food is hummus and hot dogs. If you get the higher quality hot dogs, slather on some hummus and a line of mustard. It's great, but still clearly bachelor food. So I go to this place that sells bulk food, mostly for mom and pop restaurants or big church events, that kind of stuff. I go there because you can get these great hot dog buns, $3 for a 24 pack. Then you get like half a gallon of really good hummus for $15. It's great, but I almost instantly made a horrible mistake. I came in and just 20 feet in and to my left is the bread and the buns. I come in and notice a woman. It's been a long day and I'm very hungry, so I only vaguely notice she's wearing mild business attire, just like the employees, and some sort of blue apron, just like the employees. And to top it all off, she's in front of the hot dog buns, shuffling buns off of her cart and onto the shelf. I walk up and grab the last bag of hot dog buns on her cart and loudly, playfully announce, "Yoink!" She turns around and stares at me as if I just stole her purse. Something triggers inside me, and I know something's wrong. I'm still trying to keep up my happy tone, despite how tired I am, and it takes me a full 5 seconds of this poor woman staring at me, worried and almost shivering when I finally notice. Her cart has eggs, milk, frozen items, energy drinks, and a few other various items in smaller amounts, and her purse is on the cart, and the apron is actually a blue stripe on her shirt. I nearly break down apologizing, carefully placing her hot dog buns on the cart and keep apologizing. Thankfully, she either was nice or realized how upset I had made myself with this mistake and finally has to all but grab either side of my face and say it was fine right into my eyes. I still felt horrible. I'm huge and I have to be so darn careful not to hurt people just going about my daily life, and I hate scaring innocent people. I can be mean when I need to, but I really hate being the bad guy. I got my buns and my hummus, still looking down and barely even paying attention to the world around me, letting the embarrassment and pain grind away at me when all of a sudden I hear a playful voice say, "Yoink!" And suddenly, my hummus is gone. I look over to see the woman smiling and laughing before she hands it back and tells me, "Don't tear yourself up. It was an honest mistake and you handled it really well." I still tear myself up about it, but it was a big step in the path of feeling better. Got screamed at today by Karen over an avocado. I'm full of bitter fury, so if you're a vindictive person, you may enjoy this. Little backstory. I work for a gourmet burger place. Everyone who works during this has seen the inner jerkness of the general public grow and grow. We've been slammed and understaffed because 3/4 of our staff decided to quit when this all went down, and every 10 minutes our phone rings with some dumb jerk asking, "Are you guys open? What time do you close tonight? Can I order random thing not currently offered?" First of all, Google answers every question you ask. Just Google the restaurant. Our menu is on the website. Our website is on Google. So anyways, after having the phone ring with the same crap every 5 to 10 minutes at least, and often having 3 or 4 calls come in at the exact same time, my phone customer service voice is slipping. I'm not rude, but I don't have the patience anymore to be all chipper and peppy over the phone. Today I get a call from a guest. Let's call her Jerk. So Jerk calls and asks to order. I politely direct Jerk to the online ordering platform because it will let you know what our new menu is, and we've been very busy, so it will help us get your order out more quickly. Jerk says she can't put blue cheese on her burger. I tell Jerk, "I'm sorry, ma'am, we don't have blue cheese right now. Anything you can't find online, we don't have." Jerk says,
Well, I wanted guacamole on my burger, but that button isn't there either.
Quick separate thought. Guacamole and avocado are two different things. I've worked as a server for years. You give somebody avocado when they ask for guacamole, and a crappy person will not hesitate to mess up your day with their poor social etiquette. So anyways, I begin to say to Jerk, "We actually don't sell guacamole, ma'am. We did for a while, but only for 1 month as a special. But we do not have avocado." I only get as far as ma'am. So she cuts me off and says, "I've seen burgers with guacamole or avocado or whatever that stuff is called." So I responded to her, completely ignoring that I was interrupted because what else is new? "Oh, avocado. Yes, ma'am, we do have that. If you don't see that online, it's an issue. I'm so sorry. I'll go ahead and take your order." Once again, cutting me off, she says, "Why would you split hairs between avocado and guacamole? Are you stupid?" I respond, "Well, guacamole and avocado aren't technically the same thing." And third interruption in a row, this jerk screams at the top of her lungs through the phone, "Don't you be a jerk to me!" I say for the first time, not trying to hide my irritation, "Don't yell at me. I've done nothing to deserve that." She yells some more about how they're the same thing. I explain, "If you asked for guacamole and I gave you avocado and you were upset by it, it could cause me to get an unnecessary, uncomfortable situation." And then, showing her truly undeniable stupidity and lack of self-awareness, she retorts, "What are you talking about? Who would get upset with someone over avocado?" At this point, my voice is flat and clearly upset, but I'm still not being snarky or rude, just abrupt. I retort, "People yell at food service workers about all kinds of things." Karen says, "Clearly you've had a hard day." I respond, "It was fine until a minute ago. What can I get you?" The rest of her ordering process, she's very quiet and much more respectful. I hope I broke her. I hope that realizing how mean she was, she broke down crying. I hope her husband leaves her and her kids don't call. Just to be clear, I don't actually have a legitimate problem with people calling and asking what time we close or if we're open. I know times are crazy. It just gets kind of annoying due to how often it happens, but I just wanted to get my frustrations off my chest.
You have to come watch this video next, you're gonna love it. And if you support our channel by joining as a member today, we'll give you a special shout out in our next video. And why not have us record your script for you? Just head over to our Fiverr, link pinned in the comments below.